last, everything seems to be moving for the band with the awkward name of It Bites. A deal with Virgin Records to produce 8 albums, a single in the lower reaches of the charts, now a tour of Britain and soon a tour of America. Not bad for 4 23-year-olds, 3 from Egremont and 1 from Whitehaven. They moved to London to further their careers, and only rarely do they get home to West Cumbria. And gradually, they're getting used to signing autographs, appearing on TV, and all the other trappings of success in the music industry.
Progressive, rock, clever, heavy. Basically, it's a fusion of what we think anyway is like the best bits. What we've done is not actually studied bands, but in our influences, try to take out the best parts of the strong points of other bands. Really.
Myself, Dick, and Frank went through right through school together from a very early age, and once we started playing our own instruments, we decided to form a band.
I think, well, we've been playing around the clubs around here, around this area for ages. But I think any band, if they want to get really serious, they've got to move away. You know, that's the only thing they've got to do. So we decided to move about 2 years ago to London, in the Bruffies.
Everybody's really nice, you know, the red police have seen us on telly and the, you know, the glad we're doing well. Everybody's really friendly in this bit.
Delighted to have on the Saturday Pitch Show today a brilliant new band who are called It Bites. They supported Go West last year. This is actually their first ever television appearance. They're going to be singing 2 songs for us, their new single Calling All the Heroes a little bit later on, but right now this is their last single. So we welcome to the Saturday Picture Show, singing all in red, It Bites.
All in red, you're all in red.
lead singer here, Frank.
Hello.
How are you doing?
How are you doing? All right.
I'm okay. Listen, welcome to the Pitch Show. Nice to see you here. Your new single's called Calling All the Heroes. About what?
It's actually about Hollywood B-movies.
Is it really?
Yeah, well, cowboys and Indians.
Oh, good stuff. You're going to be doing a gig tonight?
Yeah, it's in Dudley, near Birmingham.
Great, wish you luck. And you're going to be touring shortly as well?
Yeah, I've got to tour the British tour line.
Excellent, we wish you all the best. Well, you go and get
much.
Yourself ready.
Okay.
And now we welcome for the second time, singing their brand new single, Calling All the Heroes, It Bites!
Originating in Cumbria, It Bites have had a very big, big success with their latest, All in Red. Here it is. Morning.
I feel great.
Yeah. That's quite a surprise. Now, in the video we saw bits of beaches. Where was that filmed?
That was Redcar. We were doing a gig at Redcar, so we just went over there and got the video people up because it was such a nice beach.
Because you're actually from the north, aren't you? From around Carlisle. Whereabouts?
From Egremont in Cumbria.
And do you still live there?
Yeah, I live in London now. I've lived in London for about 3 years.
That's what happens to all Northerners. They just desert the North and go and live in London. Why is that?
Such is Britain, you see.
There's too much rain, you know.
In London it's like a Sahara Desert. Round about midday, it always breaks out in the Sahara Desert.
Well, whenever I go to London, it's not quite like that. It usually rains. What's so fascinating about London?
All it is just because all the things, like in the music business, all the things are there that you need, like the record companies and stuff like that. I mean, I think WA are opening an office in Thornhill, in Egremont. That's about it.
Now, you two were at school together, and that's where you started the band. So, did you play any sports there?
Yeah, I used to like sport a lot. And I used to do running and soccer, and I used to play basketball for the county.
About you.
He was one of them like big lads who could boot it up.
I was a fullback. I was fat. I was about 20 stone when I was 6.
Well, I think you slimmed down since then. But well, you could perhaps come and do some sports later and get fit with the rest of us.
Oh yeah, I'd really like to do that because I feel really good at the moment. I'm in tip-top shape and.
I call home, but I'll hold out spent the summer dressed in black. You know, to put your back against the wall. You know, there's a woman close at hand. She's with another man, and I'm alone. You know, do you remember our push against the war? You carried me home, and then you had to watch the story of my own life.
So, I think it's fair to say this is the rock and roll instrument, isn't it, really? Would you agree?
Yeah, it is. This is have so much personality and everything in it. You know, it's a type of person who plays the guitar.
Yeah, yeah.
It isn't anybody, you know, it's a type of person who plays the drums. It's a definite type of person that plays the guitar.
What kind of person is that?
Usually, like, very insecure show-offs.
Really?
Yeah.
Ah.
Not that I'm one, right?
I was going to say, it's becoming dangerously close to a bit of self-analysis there. Yeah. That business of string bending, I guess that's really the electric guitar, isn't it? Acoustic guitars, you can't achieve anything like that, can you?
Not as well. I mean, obviously, sometimes you can. You know, if you look at my fingertips, that's with playing an acoustic guitar.
Yeah.
They're absolutely awful, you know.
Yeah.
Sort of hard. And that's trying to bend on an acoustic, it sort of hurts your fingers.
And sustain as well, is that another big difference?
Yeah, you know, it goes back again to what I say. It's like the sustain comes with the attitude, you know. It's sort of,
yeah.
You're holding the note and it makes you go like, and you keep that phase until the note dies down, you know.
Yeah.
I don't know if you use the bridge to bang it, you go. You know, there's like an attitude in that.
Yeah. Do you think, can it be a delicate instrument though? Because an older generation of people would say, oh, electric guitars, it's just a racket. Can it also be
Very. I mean, even with sustain on, because a lot of the metal bands most guitarists actually are usually impressed by speed, and it isn't about that.
Right.
You know, if I go like that's actually a load of rubbish.
Yeah.
If I take off the sustain, it just goes like da, 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 da.
Yeah.
But all your notes come off because the sustain makes it sound as if every note's being played.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
If
I take the sustain off, it just sounds like.
Yeah, yeah. All about it. What is it?
Basically, it can sound anything like a cross between like an acoustic guitar and a piano. You know,
you
know, it's very sweet sounding. That sort of thing.
Yeah.
And the good thing about it is the actual speed and cleanness of the notes you can use. You know, you can like.
Yeah, I think if you just heard that and didn't see you playing the instrument, you might as well imagine it was sequenced, couldn't you? Because it's almost like a digital.
It's actually broke at the moment. I've got a bad string.
Yeah. What gave you the idea to do it, to make it?
I was doing a demo and a track of our second album called Rosemary, and I was sitting down on the 8-track, I had the 8-track recorder in front of me, and then the song was playing, and I was tapping away like that on the guitar neck, and then by accident I went and I thought, wow. So I sat down with the guitar and started working things out. Worked the solo. I'd done a full solo using that with just the guitar on the album.
Yeah, obviously it's related to the guitar, but apart from that, is there any other instrument that it bears any resemblance to?
Not really. I mean, I think you'd probably stand more chance of playing it if you're a drummer. I mean, it isn't. That's probably the nearest thing to believe it or not.
Yeah.
Because it's It's all, you know, as long as you've got rhythm in your hands, you should be able to play it and then just get a bit accurate, you know.
Yeah. There are people, aren't there, who tap on the conventional guitar, Stanley Jordan, the jazz player, and I think Jeff Healy as well, who tap on conventional guitars, aren't there, as well?
It actually isn't hard to do. It's very simple.
Yeah.
You know, people think, you know, this and Jeff Healy type style's really hard, but it's actually sometimes a lot better.
Yeah.
A lot easier, you know, to bend your nose.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
For solos and stuff, I just don't know how he does all that other stuff, man, when he's doing Jeff, I'll leave it to you, man.
So you don't intend to... You don't want to become the world's virtuoso tap board player?
No. I'm not really, it's a bit musofied, you know. I'm not really into that sort of, like, muso, like, snobby trip. I find it a bit snobbish, and I don't want to become, like, one of the, you know, it bites, oh, that's that guy with that funny instrument.
Yeah.
So, I'd rather play it at home.
You're not going to market it? You're not going to put a copyright on it, or...?
I mean, I'd have to give people lessons then, and I'm not really into that either.
All right.
I'm going to spare a couple of years, you know.
Yeah. Okay, great.